It's Magic Breakfast with Tom Price. I'm Harriet Scott. And David Tennant's on
Hi.
The show.
Good morning, everybody.
Hooray! I love a bit of David Tennant.
Oh, it's nice to be here.
I think everybody loves a bit of David Tennant.
Does anyone dislike you?
This is very much the question I asked to Olivia Colman.
Isn't it? Stop nicking all the stuff
from
the podcast.
Sorry, that is on the podcast.
It is. Yes. Well, definitely.
Okay.
But I'm glad I'm glad the perception is that that's hard to find. But I could give you a long list.
Okay, excellent.
Yeah. We'll have that afterwards.
Long
list
of filthy people.
You feel quite comfortable in a radio studio because this you're moving into our territory, quite frankly, aren't you?
A little bit. I've always really loved visiting radio studios. I've always loved listening to the radio and listening to audio stuff. There's something about something sort of intimate and you know, it's always intrigued me.
So how long have you had this idea of doing a podcast then?
It was a bit of an accident.
Oh, okay.
I've always loved radio and I've always loved podcasts, and I'm getting more and more into podcasts than indeed the world has, you know, because you can kind of curate your own radio channel, can't you?
Yeah, slightly dangerous for us, but yeah. I mean, fine, but, you know, do keep listening to Magic.
Everything has its own... But I think it's like when movies came out and people's... when TV came out and people said this will ruin the movies. It doesn't. I think it just adds another... You know, we're good beings at having we go to different places for different things.
Exactly,
I think
it's brilliant because the conversations you can have on a podcast, we don't have time for on a breakfast show.
Exactly. Yeah. So you can do a kind of long form kind of. It can ramble a bit. It can, and it can sit in someone's ears when they're on the commute home from work.
Yeah.
Because you can't get the radio in the tunnels.
No, you can get a little bit of Wi-Fi, but then it drops out in between the stations.
Oh, I can never make it work on the trains.
Getting Wi-Fi on the trains?
Yeah.
You've got about 9 different levels of passwords.
Yeah.
I'll give you my passwords afterwards. You can jump
Thanks,
on mine.
Tom,
you're
that,
absolutely welcome. Yeah. Olivia Colman, what an amazing guest to go on the podcast.
Yes.
Loving the bit when most of the podcast is Olivia Colman's dog.
The Alfred Lord Waggison. Yes, he does feature quite heavily.
What kind of a dog is it?
Oh, it's a little sort of mutt. It's very cute.
Yes.
But yes, he's a sort of, I don't know what he is, a combination of various things.
Mongrel.
Oh, he's lovely. Yeah. He's a little
scruff. That's a technical term.
You say a word like that and you...
And you wonder if that's a line
anymore.
I know,
but here we go. Isn't it?
That's
I'm looking around.
That's what it is. There it is. There's a picture.
That's fine. Yes. That's a lovely mixture of many different things. Always a scruff. Oh, I love a scruff.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Scruff. And it's a great interview with her because it's got that long form thing. And you seem to have, I'd say you might have peaked with Olivia Colman, what an amazing guest. But the people you've got coming up on this podcast is insane.
Yeah, people have said yes. That's what I think. The whole thing was a bit of an accident because I was listening to a lot of podcasts. I was away in America for a bit, so I didn't have the kids so much. So I had time to do things like that. And I was listening to Alec Baldwin is an amazing podcaster. Yeah. And I started listening to him, and he was interviewing amazing people, and just it all sounded he's so cool. Yeah. So I immediately aspired to be as cool as Alec Baldwin, and I thought nobody's doing a British version of this. And I was just having this conversation with my agent, who it turns out is also a mad podcast fan, Sarah Kamler, and she went, I'll sort it out. Oh, I'll say,
commitment.
And
suddenly
I get home from America and I'm in a meeting about a podcast, and then it's like, listen, honestly.
I don't know how much time I've got.
I'm sure nobody will want to do it. And they said, well, just try. So I phoned up Judy Whitaker, I phoned up Olivia Colman. They both went, yeah, whatever you want. And I thought, oh, we've got to do this now,
Yeah, you're committed. Once there's a date in the diary, you've got to do it. But also, did you do much research? Because often people think podcasts, you just sort of go in and you're just sort of riffing and making it up, but you've got to do a bit
of
research.
I'm too scared not to.
Right.
Yeah, so I do, even people I know quite well, obviously they're a bit easier because you've got a few sort of, you know some of the skeletons in their closets, you can rip them out. But yeah, I mean, everyone I know, everyone on the podcast I've got some sort of connection to, but some of them are like Samantha Bee, for instance, who does a sort of late night political satire show in the US.
She's so good.
Yeah,
so
she's
good.
Extraordinary. And I'd never met her. I'd done a little bit on her show, sort of via satellite. So I thought, well, that's enough of a connection. I'll do her. Mm. So with her, of course, I was like, I've never even met her. I had to do quite a lot of research. Whoopi Goldberg, I'd met a couple of times.
Sorry, did you just say Whoopi Goldberg?
I did just
pick her up for you and put that out there. So that episode has now dropped, hasn't it?
That's out. Yes, that's out now.
I have to listen to it. I haven't listened to that, but I'm going to, because I was hooked, honestly, with your chat with Olivia Colman.
I'm delighted. Good.
I absolutely loved it. And I think, obviously, we, the audience, know that we can believe that you are friends anyway, because, of course, from Broadchurch.
Yeah.
So with somebody like that, there's a trust thing there.
Yeah, I hope so.
How do you recreate that, perhaps with someone like Whoopi Goldberg? Because Olivia Colman knows, even though you talk about getting skeletons out of closets, I think she knows
it. I'm not going to do that to her. Yes,
yes,
exactly.
You're not really going to go places where they don't want to. Someone like Whoopi Goldberg, how do you get that trust? How do you get people to talk about something interesting without them thinking, well, what is this? You know, what's he going to say?
That's like a proper journalistic question. The sort of thing I don't do, Harriet. So thank you for that. I don't know. I suppose what you look for is the areas of sort of common experience, don't you? So with someone like Whoopi, who's a very different life to me, and she's been a sort of massively famous human being for most of her life, but you can kind of talk to her about the bits that where your lives do overlap, I suppose, and you can assume a sort of intimacy through that, and then hope that she did. But you also know, you know, with someone like that, she's a lovely person. She's warm. She wants to sort of have a chat.
Yeah.
And nobody's doing this who doesn't want to do it.
Yes.
That's the thing. Because of the way podcasts work, I suppose, you just have to go, listen, do you fancy this? If you don't, yeah, it's fine.
And as an actor, are you quite relieved, and do you think perhaps other people are as well, that there is this format now that people can be asked proper questions instead of you come on a breakfast show like ours and you get asked to do stupid games, which is coming up, by the way.
Good, we have
got a stupid game for you.
I would miss it if it wasn't.
And this is the thing. I mean, but sometimes you may have a film to promote or something and no one actually asks you about it.
I suppose, yeah. And to be fair, the podcast isn't really about promoting anything. It's just about finding out a bit about people and having the idea is that there is no concept. So, because when I first did it, they said, oh, and you could ask them, you know, your 10 favourite ice cream flavours. I don't really want to do that.
Format points, just riff.
It's not really my thing. I'm not really very good at all that. So it has to just, it'll just ramble and it'll be what it'll be.
How long do you spend with them then? How long are you in the room with them?
Most of them we do about a couple of hours.
Gosh.
Depending on how busy people are.
Yeah. It's a long time.
That is a long time.
Yeah. And so we do take quite a lot out, but maybe we'll, you know, do like a DVD extras episode down the line a bit.
Can you imagine?
Yeah.
Just the extended version. The Lord of the Rings trilogy. Just Jodie Whittaker talking about her lunch. I'd listen to that.
You just listen to her talk, wouldn't
you? Yes, she's so good. She's so good. So there's great people coming up on that podcast. You've got Michael Sheen, Whoopi Goldberg, that's out now. John Hamm.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, he's very cool.
Michael Sheen, best Welshman ever as well. Amazing.
Oh, it's the John Hamm. It must be the John Hamm clip that I've heard. You did a preview thing, didn't you? It's a bit rude. I'm sure there's a rude clip.
Oh, is there?
We're not
swearing.
Shy of...
It's a bit of swearing, yeah.
A bit of swearing. Does that offend you, Harry? I'm sorry.
No, not quite enjoyed it.
I'll get you a
Olivia Colman didn't hold back. I mean, there was a big word. There was a big word within minutes. I thought, oh, here we go.
She loves to swear. Yeah. She swears with great gusto.
She does. Yeah. She does.
As does Whoopi, I have to say. Yeah.
You should rename it. Yeah.
You should do, actually. Yeah. Yeah. Tennant swears with famous people.
That's pretty much it.
That's it.
That would work. Yeah.
Fantastic.
Does it leave you time to do any other projects?
Oh, yeah. It's very much a kind of... As Kristen Ritter, who's one of the guests, she went, is this your new side hustle? Because she loves a side hustle herself, because she's a knitting queen, would you believe it, as well as a cool superhero.
Side hustles are hilarious. We had Richard E. Grant on the other day. Do you know what his side hustle is?
No, what's his side hustle?
Perfume.
Oh, I did know that. Yes.
What does this mean? Does it mean making money out of something or a hobby?
Yes, hustle's a bit of making money on the side.
He has a scent out.
Yeah, it's called Jack.
Yeah, is it called Jack? Mm. Why is it called Jack?
I don't know. I did any answer, but I was too busy looking into his deep blue eyes.
I bet you were.
I didn't listen to a word he said.
Yeah.
Just staring at him.
He's mesmeric, isn't he?
He's incredible and amazing in that new film. Amazing. So he's got a perfume out.
It's almost like a hobby, isn't it? It's just sort of, it's also an excuse to hang out with some mates and kind of have a bit of time to just have a chat, really.
Mm. So when you do have to go back to the rigour and discipline of being, I'm going to put this out there, one of Britain's best actors. I can't look at you because I was embarrassed to say it.
I'm looking out the window.
No, but it's true, David. You are fantastic. And what are you doing at the moment? What can we look forward to seeing you in soon, please?
The next thing you'll see, probably, is Good Omens, which is a Neil Gaiman, Terry Pratchett novel, which Neil Gaiman has adapted, which is coming on Amazon Prime Video in a couple of months.
And who's your co-star in that?
Michael Sheen, the aforementioned.
Hello, Michael Sheen.
Yeah, and indeed John Hamm. That's where I got the two of them from.
This means we're going to be on the podcast soon, because it's basically everyone that comes into contact with David Tennant.
Literally anyone. Can you imagine?
We're around. I say we, I speak for you.
Yeah, I'm available. I'm definitely available. Hang on. Michael Sheen, David Tennant, and John Hamm all in the same TV show.
Yeah.
This is going to be insane.
Miranda Richardson's in that too.
Wow.
Yeah, some quite good people. Jack Whitehall. Quite good.
Wonderful. Very nice indeed.
I hate to bring the tone down.
Oh,
I'm going to do it in two ways.
That's
we have got a game
job.
Coming up. I'm just looking at you. Just remembered that I try and do a Broadchurch impersonation, not of you, of the music.
Oh, do you?
You know the moment where you spot the who you think is the villain or whatever, and the music goes. It's like that.
Sounds like a sort of diesel engine.
It's like. It's that.
Wow.
Isn't it? Do you know what I mean?
You know mean that sort of that bass, kind of low, threatening chord.
It's that.
Right.
It's that.
Right.
I'm really glad this is being filmed. I forgot about that.
Yeah. That definitely wasn't the Broadchurch theme tune.
It wasn't. It wasn't. But it was just that.
And then yeah. There's Doctor Who as well. He was in that.
Yeah.
You remember?
Maybe we'll edit this bit out.
Don't.
No.
This is gold.
This is gold.
Yeah. Like the podcast approach. Keep everything.
Keep everything. Let it ramble.
Exactly. Wow, amazing.
Should we move on to a game?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, but I just want you to keep going, please.
No. That isn't the game.
No.
That's this, not the game. That
that's
was
just an amuse-bouche.
I just felt moved to share that with you.
I loved it.
I'm not sure I nailed it, but does that matter?
So we've got a game where, right. Which is called the Bryan Adams 69 game. What's going to happen is we're going to sing alternative lyrics. I'm so sorry about our singing. We're going to sing alternative lyrics to that song, and then you have to retort with what year you think we're singing about. But you have to sing, was the summer of 83.
I love the concept.
Right.
It's quite complex, isn't it?
Would you like to start?
Yes, I would. I'd like to sing to David Tennant.
Okay,
come on. Here
we go. Dream come true. Here we go.
Oh, that's like...
It was the first Red Nose Day.
Oh, now
Tom Hanks was big. Phil Collins had a groovy kind of love.
Was a summer of... No, I'm just working it out.
No, come on, quicker.
Oh,
quicker.
I have to be quicker than that.
Yeah, was the summer of...
Nearly.
About
4.
Oh!
Okay, it's all right. We'll play another one.
Okay. Oh, it's quite tense.
Batman begun. England won the Ashes. You became Doctor Who.
I can do this.
Was a summer of
2005.
Yes!
Thank you.
Come on! Fantastic.
You slightly gave it away to me at the
Straight
end.
Straight off the bat, things you have done.
Yeah.
All right, okay.
I'm tempted to leave it there. We do have another one, but
come
we should...
Oh,
okay,
no, keep
fine.
It coming.
But you just might not end on a high, that's all. Okay, all right, here we go. Mission Impossible fell out. Stormzy won loads of Brits. Toys R Us bit the dust.
Was it summer of
2014, 15, 16,
17? Yes, 17. He got it right. He always gets it right.
You're right, I should have got out while I was ahead, shouldn't I?
Oh, that was great. That was great. We must do a version of this where it's just things that our guest has done. That's what we need to do
it's
next time.
It's so much easier.
Just, you were
What's
Doctor
annoying
Who.
Me, though, is, and this is unlikely because I'm not a sports person, but I would have got it from the Ashes one. And then because you did... I would...
Yeah,
because you then did the Doctor Who bit, it looks like I only know, but I'm totally narcissistic.
Typical
until the
actor.
Test.
Yeah. Bring it back to himself and he's there.
But because we were filming Doctor Who when they won it, and our director was a massive cricket fan, and I learned the rules of cricket because we were winning the Ashes. England were winning the Ashes. I wasn't. I'm from Scotland. Mm-hmm. I've just been kicked out of my own country.
To be very clear,
And I remember being taught the rules to cricket on the set. It does still come back to me on the set of my first
because
season.
It was that right. Okay,
narcissism
so it was still about
still
you. Unbelievable.
Here. Okay.
Well, if you enjoy narcissism, then you're going to love David Tennant's new
podcast. Brave,
very true.
Do
very
you want
true.
Him to come back?
Oh, it's fantastic. It's a fantastic listen, and there are some incredible guests on there.
David Tennant, thank you for
thank
coming
you
on
very
Magic
much
Breakfast.
For having me.